Uganda's third biggest export commodity after coffee and fish, the tea sector, still remains constrained by many challenges along the entire value chain due to lack of regulations. Stakeholders in the tea sector are bothered that the continued absence of the national tea policy has continued to compromise the development of the sector. They always face the challenge of fake inputs and lack of fertilizers.
We have lost the fertilizer supply mechanism. Tea farmers do not access fertilizers. So the acreage we are talking about is yielding less than half of the potential. We have lost quality control capacity as a country. Uganda tea quality is suffering.
Onesmus Masko, the chairperson of the Uganda Tea Outgrowers Association, emphasized the critical need for a national tea policy that will provide the much-needed guidance and coordination.
Our national acreage is giving less than half of the potential. Even without distributing any more seedlings, we can, at the minimum, double Uganda's tea production, and all that needs the facilitation, the coordination, the guidance of a national tea policy.
Catherine Katosabe and Mutunji McLean, women farmers of the Uganda Tea Outgrowers Association, shed light on the captivating evolution of Uganda's tea industry. However, they expressed a need for government to give a special fund to the tea growers to boost their yields.
But the biggest challenges women are facing are lack of inputs, which are subsidized like fertilizer, herbicides, and which are at a higher cost. So it is difficult for women in tea to get themselves these fertilizers, which are not fake.
Limited funds, gender-based violence, lack of enough land, and many more. So we decided to form this association with a name of sorting out all these issues.
Tea contributes 3.6% of Uganda's export earnings, making the country earn over $72 million. Tea industry stakeholders believe this can be doubled if there was a policy in place to regulate the sector, especially in terms of quality and production, which affects prices on the international market compared to its Kenya and Rwanda counterparts. The State Minister for Agriculture, Bwino Chakulaga, assured farmers that they have already embarked on creating a policy to regulate the sector. Once this policy is passed into law, it will address key issues including strengthening research, extension services, post-harvest handling, processing, trade and marketing, with all these aimed at improving the quality of Uganda's made tea, profitability and competitiveness.
Now the world demands too much. The market demands are big. The consumers are demanding a lot of quality, innovation, and so on and so forth.
In Uganda currently, tea is being grown in the districts of Chenjojo, Bushenyi, Buhweju, Mukono, Isingiro, Ntungamo, Mitoma, Rubirizi, Kamwenge, Mbarara, Kisoro, Kabale, Zombo, and Nebbi, giving a combined 45,000 acres of Uganda's tea growing area. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.